Hi everyone. In this video, let us discuss one of the new medication, Flibanserin. Flibanserin is one of the recently developed medication approved by FDA in 2015. Here we can identify the suffix serin, that means this drug acts on the serotonin. Flibanserin is one of the serotonin receptor modulator. That means this drug can act as both agonist as well as antagonist on serotonin receptors. That's why it is called as modulator. Then what is the use of this drug? Flibanserin is particularly indicated in the premenopausal women who are suffering with hypoactive sexual desire disorder, commonly known as HSDD. In such women, flibanserin can be given in order to increase sexual desire and improve the symptoms of libido. Initially, this drug was introduced as antidepressant, but later it is approved for this indication in premenopausal women. This drug acts as a modulator on 5-HT receptors, so it can target 5-HT 1A receptor as well as 5-HT 2A receptors. This drug can act as agonist on 5-HT 1A receptors. At the same time, it can act as antagonist on 5-HT 2A receptors. So its main action is on the modulation of serotonergic transmission within the CNS. Apart from its action on serotonin, it can also affect norepinephrine as well as dopamine levels within the CNS. All these can improve the symptoms in the premenopausal women with loss of libido. At the same time, this medication is not suitable for all the people. This flibanserin is not suitable for postmenopausal women. So it is only indicated in premenopausal women. Similarly, this drug is not intended for children as well as it is not indicated in the men. And this drug just improves the symptoms of libido in the premenopausal women. But within the premenopausal women, all women are not suitable for the treatment. Sometimes loss of libido can be observed because of many of the factors. For instance, a loss of libido can be observed in the people having trouble in relations. In such conditions, flibanserin is not effective. And in those people with any mental conditions or psychiatric conditions, where the loss of libido is connected with psychological behavior, again, flibanserin is not effective. Similarly, in the conditions where loss of libido is produced because of use of medications, again, this drug is ineffective. Today in this video, we are going to discuss how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug acts. We have already discussed that flibanserin acts on CNS, and particularly it acts on prefrontal cortex, where it can modulate the transmission of 5-HT. Within the prefrontal cortex, serotonergic transmission is very important. So these are the presynaptic serotonergic neurons, and this is the postsynaptic serotonergic neuron. On this postsynaptic neuron, we can find different types of 5-HT receptors. This is the 5-HT 2A receptor, and this is the 5-HT 1A receptor. Now, normally when 5-HT is released, it can act on the 5-HT 2A receptors, as well as it can act on the 5-HT 1A receptors. And the final effect of released 5-HT depends on how these receptors are activated. Now, flibanserin can bind to these 5-HT 2A receptors, where it can act as antagonist, and it can inhibit the activity of 5-HT through these 5-HT 2A receptors. Similarly, it can bind to 5-HT 1A receptor, but at this time it can act as agonist, thereby it can modulate the transmission of 5-HT. Because of these two actions, flibanserin can reduce the 5-HT release within the CNS, thereby it can reduce the serotonergic transmission within the CNS. Apart from these actions, it can also improve the transmission of norepinephrine as well as dopamine. Because of increased transmission of norepinephrine and dopamine, along with reduction of 5-HT release and its transmission, the symptoms of loss of libido in premenopausal women are improved, thereby restoring the normal functionality. In this way, flibanserin can be used in the premenopausal women to treat hypoactive sexual desire disorder. Now let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of flibanserin is that since this drug acts on the CNS, it can produce central side effects. One of its central action is to produce hypotension, which is induced centrally. Because of this hypotension, when this flibanserin is given, the patient should measure the blood pressure during the therapy. And in case of any symptoms of hypotension, care should be taken while driving with vehicles or working with machinery. In order to eliminate this hypotension, this drug is preferred to be taken at bedtime. But still, it can produce some hypotensive episodes on the next day. Therefore, care should be taken while using the flibanserin to check any significant hypotension in the people. In the woman with hepatic impairment, the hypotensive effect is more pronounced since flibanserin is metabolized within the liver. But in the people with hepatic impairment, the metabolism is impaired, resulting in the increased levels of flibanserin, which produce significant hypotension. That's why this drug is contraindicated in the people with hepatic impairment in order to avoid significant hypotension and syncope in the people. Second important precaution is that along with hypotension, flibanserin can also increase the risk of syncope, falling sensation, risk of injuries. This is particularly more observed during the daytime, during the working hours. That's why flibanserin should be taken only at the bedtime with at least 6 to 8 hours gap between the intake and daytime working hours. Next one is the effect of alcohol. Alcohol acts as a CNS depressant. At the same time, flibanserin is also act as CNS depressant. So when both of these are combined, they can produce significant hypotension, which is fatal to the patient. That's why alcohol should not be combined with flibanserin. This combination can affect both systolic blood pressure as well as diastolic blood pressure. The systolic blood pressure may be reduced around 28 to 54 millimeter of mercury, and diastolic blood pressure may be dropped by 24 to 46 millimeters of mercury. These reductions are highly significant, where they produce a fatal hypotensive stage, resulting in fainting and syncope. That's why alcohol should not be combined with flibanserin, and blood pressure should be thoroughly checked during the therapy with flibanserin. Similarly, flibanserin can produce some CNS depression, so it can produce various symptoms like somnolence, sleepiness in the people. That's why they should take care while working with machinery or driving the vehicles. It can also produce some dizziness, lightheadedness, some imbalance in the body, dullness and less activeness, less concentration may be observed. Even it can produce some fatigue, lack of energy. All these effects can be observed with flibanserin. These effects may be further enhanced when this drug is given with other CNS depressants like alcohol. That's why alcohol should be avoided. Even with other drugs which are producing again CNS depression, this flibanserin should be carefully used. Another important precaution is on its metabolism. Flibanserin is going to be converted into its metabolites within the liver by cytochrome P450 system. Among these, CYP3A4 is one of the important enzymes. The activity of this enzyme is modulated by many of the drugs which can affect the metabolism of flibanserin. For instance, strong CYP3A4 inhibitors can inhibit the metabolism of flibanserin, which increase its levels, leading to significant hypotension. So drugs like ketoconazole, itraconazole, clarithromycin, ritonavir, and so many strong CYP3A4 inhibitors should not be combined with flibanserin in order to avoid significant hypotension and syncope in the people. Then what about the moderate CYP3A4 inhibitors? They can also affect the metabolism of flibanserin and they can produce significant hypotension. So drugs like ciprofloxacin, fluconazole, diltiazem, verapamil, all these are the moderate CYP3A4 inhibitors. Again, they should not be combined with flibanserin. So when these drugs are required to be used, then there should be 2 days gap between the termination of flibanserin and initiation of these drugs. But when these drugs are already in use, then immediately flibanserin should not be started. At least 2 weeks gap should be there between the stopping of these drugs and use of flibanserin. In this way, by giving a significant gap between use of these drugs, we can eliminate a significant drug interaction between these drugs. Now let us see the side effects of flibanserin. One of the important side effects produced by this drug is the dizziness, lightheadedness. It can also produce some nausea, somnolence, sleepiness in the people, and even it can increase the symptoms of anxiety. All these are the important side effects of flibanserin. How it is given? This drug is available as a tablet at a strength of 100 mg. Dose of flibanserin is 100 mg given at bedtime. Already we have discussed that this drug should not be taken during the daytime in order to avoid any significant hypotension and syncope. It should be preferably taken at the bedtime. And this therapy can be used up to 8 weeks. So after 8 weeks, if sufficient response is not observed, then this drug should not be continued as it is ineffective after 8 weeks of the treatment. So that's all about this drug, flibanserin. Flibanserin is a serotonin receptor modulator. This drug can be used in the premenopausal women who are having hypoactive sexual desire disorder, which is not affected by use of medications, not affected by trouble in relations or psychiatric conditions of the people. In such conditions, this drug can be used to increase the libido, and it can be given at a dose of 100 mg given at bedtime. But all the people are not suitable. Patient should be thoroughly screened before use of this drug. And those people who are suitable for the treatment without any risk factors, they are prescribed with flibanserin at a 100 mg dose given at bedtime. Hypotension and syncope are the important side effects, and this drug should not be combined with other CNS depressants such as alcohol. Strong as well as moderate CYP3A4 inhibitors produce a significant drug interaction with this drug. So all these points should be carefully checked before use of this drug. So that's all about this drug, flibanserin. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.